Hey there, today I'll be talking about Sword Art Online, more specifically, Digi Bro talking about Sword Art Online Season 2. Me and Neo did the math on how we're going to make this video. There's not enough for two videos, but there's too much for one video. We're going to add a little bit between these videos, but we're not going to wait one whole week to put out the next one. As soon as the next one is done, we'll put that one out. Our goal is to have that done within like 2 days, and we'll try to have another video out 7 days after this one comes up. With that being said, let's get started. When watching Sword Art Online, it reminded me of a show, and no, not .hack, because I haven't seen .hack even till this day. Two shows if you count Platoon, but Platoon, you're not trapped in a virtual reality world, you're just brought to an island that is like the game you're playing. The show that came to mind, well, I guess I'll just show you.
A way to plug the five senses directly into the game world. The player would just wear what we call an immersion cap. Slip it on and zap. You're in Everlot. Well, it seems that once you're in the game, you can't get out until you win.
Can't you just slip the cap off?
We tried that with him.
The little guy looks fine.
Impossible did Sword Art Online before Sword Art Online. Well, at least the animating part. And let me tell you, if you think SAO is rushed, Kim Possible went and beat the MMO in one episode. Would Kim Possible destroy Kirito? Nah, not unless they got Rufus on their team. But enough with these jokes, let's get on with the actual video.
At least we would have, were it not for the fact that somehow Gungale Online began to heal the series' reputation which Alfheim had shattered.
Well, it's a bit hard to do any worse than what the second arc did to Sword Art Online. You would have to make an anime like Pupa to do any worse.
The first episode is called The World of Guns, which would actually sound kind of rad if I didn't know any better.
I don't see much of your point right there, unless you mean it's edgy or something, saying The World of Guns. It's a reference to Sword Art Online Arc 1 being called The World of Swords. It's called The World of Guns because everyone uses guns besides Kirito and Death Gun.
Kirito then explains that in Gungale Online you can exchange your in-game currency for real-world currency, which is why there are so many passionate high-level players. Once again, this is something that happens in MMOs in real life already, but not on official terms. That said, I can't imagine how or why this system would actually work in an official capacity.
Apparently, World of Warcraft actually has something like this now, although it wasn't part of the game back when you made this point. It isn't to the extreme that Sword Art Online does it, but you can pay the in-game currency for your subscription. But remember, World of Warcraft actually does sell a lot more than just the subscription. There is the pets, the mounts, the little toys, expansions, recruiter friends, and the auto-leveled characters. They have a lot to sell besides just the subscriptions. This is the closest thing that they will probably ever do to the exchange, just like how Sword Art Online does it. They're not going to actually give you money, but it will pay for your subscription. They also kind of made an official way to buy gold from Blizzard, but that's by buying BOE items from the store and then selling those on Auction House or Trade Chat. But if they went to the extent that Sword Art Online did, it would very well be the death of the game.
We close out on the horribly obnoxious opening theme, which, by the way, I highly recommend that everyone watch my AMV where I set this opening video to that one fucking horrible Hawthorne Heights song. It's legitimately my favorite thing I've ever made, and I've watched it like 30 times. Seriously, go do it.
Meh, I watched it 3 times. It's okay, but it had an abrupt ending. You should have faded the music out a little instead of just instantly stopping it.
Mustache Guy explains that in this game, only real guns are effective against other players, whereas they kill monsters using energy guns. Because players who focus on killing monsters primarily use and assumably spec towards energy guns, they are easy prey for player killers using real guns. In other words, the PvP in this game is horribly fucking broken and makes no sense because Reki Kawahara doesn't know shit about MMORPGs.
But there is still the same system inside other MMORPGs. Just look at World of Warcraft. By the way, the only reason I'm using World of Warcraft is because it's so familiar for most people. World of Warcraft has both PvP and PvE armor. Most people who have PvP armor would also spec towards PvP so that they can kill players. People who have PvE armor would spec towards PvE so that they can kill monsters. Sure, players eventually start getting PvE armor that becomes better than the PvP armor, but that's only for world PvP, and it also takes quite a while. To get PvE armor that good, you actually have to go out and do the raids. While to get a full set of PvP armor, it doesn't even take all that long, with the exception of it takes a while to do a full arena gear. This happens every expansion that I've played in World of Warcraft. PvP armor always starts out better until you're actually doing the raids. But when you're doing the raids, you're rolling against a number of people that are all trying to get the armor as well. And you can only do it once a week. In fact, right when you hit the max level, if you can't go do the heroics or the rage, you should go do the war and replace your green items with purple items. Unless this has changed since the last time I played, you can get a full set of PvP armor from the honor points within 1 to 2 weeks. While how long does it take for you to get the stuff from the raids? Well, good luck. You can constantly roll and miss. It all depends on your luck. But for me, it always took a couple of months.
When the big guy catches her before she has time to shoot, she gets the drop on him by jumping an absolutely insane distance into the direction of his fire, and for whatever reason, he just isn't capable of raising the gun fast enough to shoot her before she can get into point-blank range and annihilate him. At this point, it's less a matter of Shinon being the best sniper in the game, and more just that she's unstoppably, unbelievably overpowered.
Nah, I think Shinon's actually the best sniper in the game. From what I've seen, everyone in SAO are just too dumb to even play the game. I'm surprised they could even equip the nerve gear on. I don't even think Kirito's all that overpowered. I just feel everyone else is borderline special. Although he does glitch.
I'm coining the term remembering hate, as in, oh yeah, I remember why I hate this fucking show. Because it thinks that Lolly, who's always getting tentacle groped, is an actual characterization.
Agreed.
Anyways, this episode gives us our first look at my favorite thing in SAO2, the Spurned Women's Club. This group, consisting of the girl who fell in love with Kirito in episode 3, the girl who fell in love with Kirito in episode 7, and Kirito's sister, who's been in love with him forever, follow Kirito and Asuna around so they can bask in the glow of their unyielding jealousy with only one another for comfort. Seriously, this is a thing. All of Kirito's rejected would-be girlfriends just follow him and his girlfriend around. It's amazing. I assume Asuna lets them stay just to look down on them.
You're right, this is actually pretty amazing inside the show.
Kirito then visits this creepily flirtatious nurse and jumps into the game.
Neo, do you have a nurse outfit? No, wait, don't drop it!
Kirito plays this little bullet dodging game and immediately displays a better understanding of the game's mechanics than most of its longtime players because he's some kind of virtual MMO new type.
Literally, I just boil it down to they're all retarded.
Seriously, is predicting the prediction lines really that novel of a concept? Wouldn't high-level players have discovered this technique, like, immediately? Let's go!
Well, shit, if they don't learn immediately, they're gonna die like that a lot. It's a very basic thing for gamers just to learn what the next person's gonna do before they even do it. And Gun Gale even helps people with the prediction lines. Even if it had no prediction lines, people would still be predicting the prediction lines. Hell, people would actually be a step ahead of predicting the prediction lines. They would be predicting what they're going to do right before predicting the prediction lines. I'm really confused about this game. Was this game a noobs-only game and Kirito, Death Gun, and Shinon all hacked into it? Meh, I'm not disagreeing with Digi, but Zoro Line's just this dumb, I had to say something.
Funny then that most of the shows I've ragged on in this way have Yuki Kajiura soundtracks. Had she not also done the soundtracks to a bunch of shows that I liked, I would think it was some kind of curse.
I agree with that. Hopefully the curse will be lifted.
Next, we see Shinon in her underwear, and something about this scene made me feel really old all of a sudden. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not offended or anything by underwear shots, and I'm a far cry from someone who doesn't like fan service, but I couldn't get over the feeling that I'm watching a kids' show and that this kiddie fan service was just not made for me.
Yep, Sora Online should have just went full hentai right there. It would have made for a much better show. I guess we still always have doujinshis, though.
By the way, if they ever made SAO Survivor t-shirts, I will be on that shit.
You and me both. My friends always wanted to watch it. I didn't like it the first time I watched it. I didn't like it the second time I watched it, and I certainly did not like it the 9th time I watched it.
Next, Kirito and Shinon have a match together, and I swear to God, this scene was designed specifically to piss people like me off.
No, I was pissed off before this happened. This scene just made me turn off my computer for a while. I eventually got back to the show, for some reason.
Why am I watching this?
I ask myself the same question every single time. Continue in part 2.